People, good morning. You already know who it is. It's Arsenio Buck, man. We are reported live again. Guys, I am so grateful this morning. First and foremost, before I go out... this is going to be a funny one. Before I go out on a rant, a good rant, I first have to always give my gratitude. So, for people living in Amman, Jordan, I said this yesterday, Nassau, Bahamas... Basra, Iraq, Dulwich, UK, Prague, Czech Republic, Chelsea, UK. Okay, I say that with the undertone, just saying. No, I'm kidding. I don't give a damn about football. Lingen, Germany, Patna, India, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. I can't even pronounce this other place in the Czech Republic, and I can't even pronounce this place in the Netherlands. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in to my stuff. I am so grateful for all of you, especially the folks in Albania, man. I think that's just cool. Can you guys, man, just imagine that someone from Albania connected with you. See, guys, we are human beings. We want connections. We want to be heard. We want our voice to be heard. So I've got to be grateful this morning. But you know what? Guys, I've already created this podcast. And I don't know what happened to it. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know if I restarted my phone. It disappeared. Hopefully, I didn't already upload it. And then next, you know, I'm going to upload it again. It's just really, really weird. I don't know what happened. I got to get better at this. And you know what? Doing it from the iPhone, it does kind of suck because I can't schedule my posts so I don't get my drafts all completely mixed up. But nonetheless, guys, it's time to talk about quitting that bullshit-ass job. Excuse my French. Guys, this is so funny because yesterday... Well, things are happening here, and of course, there's always increases on my plays, and there's always increases on my website, my views, and stuff like that, and I like to tune in because every time I talk about a job, there's always a massive increase here in Thailand. I don't know who's listening to me. I don't know who is doing the listening. I don't know anything, right? But the fact of the matter is that my voice is being heard. Now, yesterday's podcast, I was speaking in the undertone. I was speaking it from the heart. I was keeping it real, people. All right? And this is ultimately going to correlate into today's podcast. Because Gary Vee has once said, he said, quit your bullshit job because you can always get another one. Guys, the 80-20 rule. Are you unhappy? I saw this post probably sometime last week. I can't remember when. It had to be Tuesday or Wednesday. And these people were just complaining on Gary Vee's little LinkedIn page about so many different things. Now, I'm going to speak to you about what I saw on the LinkedIn page. I put it in a block quote on my blog. Okay? Now, with all due respect to this human being, if you end up listening to this in the next 20 years, okay, you're going to get some heart. Welcome to the heart University of Hard Knocks, baby. But at the same time, I'm just going to read from what I saw and how I wrote it from the LinkedIn page on here. If you are not a native English speaker, by all means, no disrespect. If you are someone from America and you have this type of, I understand where you're, let's just get right into this. Guys, I'm just telling you, I'm just going to read it out loud from what I saw on LinkedIn. So here we go. I disagree. Why I didn't like my job's last 10 years, it don't fit my needs. So I quit for another low-paying job, so on due to lack of skills. One time it took me 2 months to get a job. Yes, I was out there 40-hour week looking for a job. So no, can't quit my job, which I would love to unless miracle happens. End quote. This is what an anonymous guy said. Well, actually, he had his name, but I don't even want to put his name out there. It doesn't matter what his name is. But guys, he said he couldn't get a job due to the lack of skills. Why do you think that is? I mean, just reading this guy's grammar and everything, he could polish up on that very easily. He could get himself an academic book and he could start figuring out, you know, what areas, why isn't he getting a job? Is it because he's not doing enough volunteering? Is he not learning from the greats? Is it because his mindset? It's a multitude of things. But the thing is, I'm going to be honest with you. A lot of people out there in the world have this type of grammar. And then they wonder why can't I get a job? Now, I know. A lot of you right now, you're like, hey, Arsenio, hey. You haven't been able to get a job either. And the thing is, I live in Thailand. All right. I've already told you guys the story. I'm not even going to repeat it because it's not it's the false reality of what reality truly is. See, reality is a utopic phenomenon because the world is for us. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I'm not going to say, oh, well, I didn't get a job because I am fill in the blank. I ain't going to do that. I'm not going to do that. But you know what? I do believe I'm not getting a job because it is not my job to work for someone else. Do you understand? Now, yes, I'm on the cusp. Today or tomorrow, yes, I'm on the cusp of agreeing to terms. And I'm going to remain in this country. But guys, that's just the primary job. That's all it is. That's all it is. It's just something to pay the bills. That's it. But at the same time, all the big things that are happening right now with my content writer, oh, it's on fire. It is on absolute fire right now. So, listen, you lack the skills. Well, what skills are you lacking? What did they say? Now, remember, I had a job interview back, back in January or February. It was with a woman in Chile, Providencia. And she said, oh, well, you know what? Other teachers were more qualified than you. I laughed. And I said, if you're going to choose someone based on qualifications, you have already lost. And you know what? I probably wasn't going to accept the job anyways. No, that's not my egoism talking. But did I want to hurry up and give up on Thailand in the midst of all the chaos that was happening at the beginning of this year? No. Guys, what skills are you lacking? See, that's why you have to become more resourceful. Listen to me. Listen to me. Please listen to me. Baby, I'm on the preaching mode this morning. Guys, if you're lacking skills, become more resourceful. Guys, I'm just, now, but the thing is, a lot of people say, so are you a teacher? No, I can't say that anymore. I'm a coach. I'm a mentor. I'm an educator. I'm not a teacher. I'm not a person who just goes to class, opens up a book, and teaches page by page. Fuck that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not. If they say, oh, are you a teacher? I'm like, you know what? Teaching is probably 15% of what I do. Yes. But the thing is, I also coach. Like right now, I'm coaching. I'm educating right now. I don't believe I'm actually teaching. And teaching is kind of like the regurgitation that has been happening in the last 200 years in these bullshit ass schools and universities. Ooh, I ran out of breath. But you guys understand where I'm coming from. If I'm lacking skills or whatnot, that's why I couldn't get a job to begin with here in Thailand. Well, it could be because of other reasons, but I'm just going to state it because based on my qualifications and what I had at the beginning. What was my resume when I first came here? Nothing. All I did was teach probably about 30 hours at my alma mater out there in Rancho High School in North Las Vegas, Nevada. That is it. That's all I did. But you know what? Going forward, I said, okay, now I'm going to go to this next job. Teach at a technical college. Now, is that going to enable me to get better jobs? No. But when I started working for a language center and I learned, okay, teaching conversation, presentations, business English, TOEIC, TOEFL, IELTS, academic writing, general, all of these things, I became more resourceful. And now I'm just undeniably the motherfucking man. Now, yes, there are still a lot of jobs that just do not accept me, but because maybe it's just not meant to be. Or maybe it's because of fill in the blank. I have no idea. But at the same time, those same people, they're going to know me very, very soon. See, I have the skills. If you don't have the skills, what the hell are you going to do about it? So you're telling me you were out there looking for jobs 40 hours per week, whatever country you're in, and you couldn't find anything. Hell, I understand. There's probably, hey, recessions are going on, et cetera, et cetera. But looking at what your grammar is, if your native tongue is English, I can tell why you're not getting a job. And you know what? It could be because your mental fortitude. It could be because you know your positive mental attitude. Because it could be because you have the NMA instead of the PMA, negative mental attitude instead of the positive mental attitude. You understand what I'm saying? So, guys, no excuses. The bottom line is, if you're going after a low-paying job, you're going to get low-paying results. If you're trying to, a lot of people say, "Oh, well, I graduated with a master's degree in architect from New York University and I can't even get a job at McDonald's," because you're way too goddamn overqualified for McDonald's. What are you trying to do trying to get a job at McDonald's? Oh, because I need to pay the bills. Stop trying to just pay the bills. Look at the bigger picture. What is it that you truly want? You need connections. You're an architect. Get your ass to Dubai. Get your ass to Malaysia. Get your ass to Singapore. Or get your ass here to Bangkok, because there are condominiums going up everywhere. And a lot of foreigners are invested into this stuff. A lot of people are looking for architects to do work and to come up with maps and everything here in Thailand. One of my students, she was an architect, and I didn't know anything about LinkedIn or anything back then. And I wish I did, because then I could tell her, hurry up, create a LinkedIn page, get yourself out there, start communicating in English with other people. But I didn't know that back then. But that's what I would tell her now. But you know what? She ended up going to a university in Wales. She ended up doing a whole degree out there. And now she's on to the next venture in her life. See, another guy said, what is a BS job, though? A bullshit job? A job that basically you're a number and that you could be removed and replaced at any given moment. That's basically practically every job from $8 an hour to $15 an hour out there in America. Probably $20 an hour if you want to put it that way. Hell, even the dental hygienists and the nurses are just a number. The doctors, the hospitals, they don't give a shit about you. HR doesn't give a shit about you. I know, a lot of you in right now. I don't know why my internet just keeps going in and out sometimes. Oh, it's because people probably email me. But anyway, sorry about that, guys. There's probably a little bit of a delay. But this job right now that I'm probably going to accept fully today and sign up everything, this one, I'm going to be on a live camera. I'm going to create my brand and their brand. I'm going to be empowering. It's not about just teaching anymore. It's about encouraging and empowering the students. It's about debating. It's about giving themselves ideas and watching videos and doing this. Oh my God, I'm going to take over. It's over. I win. And see, it took a long time for me to get to this point because I had that bullshit-ass job just about a year ago, all right? I was working there 3.5 years. That old guy would come in and say, oh, excuse me, Arsenio, you know what? I just don't think you're good enough. How about you take the SAT with me? Like, what is the SAT got to do with empowering, teaching conversations, teaching presentations, and giving Thai students an idea that they could take home and that they could flourish? That's called a bullshit-ass job. Those jobs that just pay those meaningless, you know, $13 an hour, $16 an hour, that is a bullshit-ass job. You're much bigger than that. You need to think outside the box. If you're asking yourself, oh, what's a BS job, though, it's probably something that you have at that specific moment. Whatever it is you have. Because if you're asking yourself that question, you already know what it is. Oh, my God. There was another guy. All right, let me state this other one. He said, not sure who this guy is, but why would anyone be asking him permission to do anything? Many people don't quit their jobs because they have bills to pay. Some people enjoy their jobs. And many people cannot find good jobs that will pay to keep the standard of living they are accustomed to. People like this think that it is simple to just quit and move on. Newsflash, there may not be opportunities or openings. See, that's bullshit. That is bullshit. Okay, but anyways, let's keep on reading this. There are many history major graduates who work as cooks. That's because they haven't become resourceful and they're not building a brand out there. So go ahead and quit. If you think you are going to just be able to find exactly what you want at that pay you need at the drop of a hat, then you are sadly mistaken. See, this is what we've become. Guys, a lot of you guys are on those autonomous jobs right now, if I could just put it that way. I'm talking about autonomous. I'm talking about things that are going to be ruled by machines in probably 10 to 40 years' time. That's a bullshit job. This guy has got it all completely reversed. He said, oh, maybe there are no opportunities or openings out there. Oh, I know a lot of history major graduates. Well, because you went to school and you learned about history and you're a graduate of history, what job can you possibly have in the end? Oh, a teacher. That's it? That's it? Guys, it's kind of like graduating in business management. What job are you going to have in the end? Honestly, all business management graduates, you have all failed. Because you pay 100,000 baht, or and I'm sorry, 100,000 US dollars over the course of 4 years. And you can't get a job nowhere. No shit, because you are a business management graduate. All of these majors and these universities around the world are going to get you jack shit. And that's the truth. You know what? That business management degree, you could have worked with Gary Vee for a year. And you know what? You could have sent in your resume and everything. And you know what? You could have learned more in 1 year than you could have learned in 4 years at university. And so many people have said this. How about you go volunteer or go, you know, send your email into Google and say, you know what, I would like to be a janitor at your facilities and see what they do. Look what they do. It's just like Les Brown's story in terms of the disc jockey. Do you guys not know that story? Les Brown first went to this guy. He had a mentor by the name of Mr. Washington. Then he went to this guy and he said, you know what? I want to be a disc jockey. He's like, do you have any experience? He's like, no. He's like, well, you know what? Sorry, we don't have a job here for you. He came back the next day. He said, you know what? Hey, how you doing? My name is Les Brown. I would like to be a disc jockey. He's like, I know who you are. You were just here yesterday. Why are you here again? He's like, well, I don't know. Maybe someone died or got sick or something. He's like, no one died. No one got sick. Now get on out of here and don't come back here. He came back the following day. He said, hey, my name is Les Brown. The guy looked at him. He said, go get me a coffee. He said, hey, yes, sir. See, people give up after that one simple time. But you know what? Les Brown's, you know, that calling, it came because this guy I forgot his name, but he was basically drunk on air. And you know what? The guy who denied him all those jobs, he's like, listen, I want you to go in there and I want you to remove him, say the shows, but don't you say anything else. Do you hear? And you know what's funny? Les Brown was looking at the guy who was slurring his speech the entire time through the window. He's like, oh yeah, he's drunk right now. My opportunity has arrived. See guys, it's all about just getting in the door, just as I got in the door here in Thailand. And of course, Les Brown ended up, you know, just saying that whole spurt and that guy gave him a job. He ended up making an insane amount of money just like that. See, opportunities come around you and they're around you everywhere. The breadcrumbs, you've got to realize them. If you think you're just, you know, a lot of people say, oh, just go ahead and quit. Go ahead and quit. That's what I did at my recent job. That job I was with 3.5 years. Hey, it took one night or it took one afternoon on a Saturday for this guy to say, I don't think you're good enough. I felt that thing go right down my spine. He said, oh, you're going to have a meeting with me if you want to continue working here. And of course, just a year prior to that, I told him, hey, you know what? I think you're a wife tourist. You came here to marry a wife, marry a woman so you could, you know, blah, 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 blah. And it's just it's a sad story. I feel like nothing but empathy for the guy, but he was trying to get back at me and he had that opportunity. And I said, you know what? Fuck all you guys. Your students suck. This is a nasty, racist province. I'm getting the hell out of here. And so I left. And just, of course, recently, over the last couple of days, there are people who are, they're unapologetic of who I am. They take me for granted. They keep saying, oh, well, this isn't good enough. Do this, do that. And I say, you know what? Goodbye. We're done. And just like that, yes, I'm going to quit that job. And you know what? That was good money. Oh, yeah. That was two big projects. I literally just swept right underneath me. Why? Because it was making up 80% of my unhappiness. And being around one particular individual there, who she's not woman enough to come up to me and talk to me over the last 3 months, hey, I'm done. That's right. I quit that bullshit-ass part-time job because I had to for my peace of mind. So, when in saying that, if you got bills to pay, you got all this, and you're not happy, go look for another job while you're still working. No excuses. If you're just going to stay at work and not do anything and not put any action behind anything, you are going to fail at life just as everyone else has or is at this specific moment. I see these cars driving down this road right now. I see all these people on these motorcycles. And you know what? They're going to drive over a bridge and they're going to drive over a river called the Chao Phraya River. They're going to get into the business district. They're going to walk into work with their head down, with their shoulders rolled over forward. And they're going to sit at their desk and engage in shit that they do not like. All of these people who are going into town right now. Hey, you make that decision every day. And you have the power to say, you know what? Enough is enough. I'm going to face fear and I'm going to take the risk. That's what I'm telling all of you to right now. All of you to do right now. And you know what? There was one last quote. And he said, please, if you do see this post, know that it's a message inside about taking barriers out of your life, not the title of the past itself that I was interested in. My current job is not bullshit, and I respect myself and employment enough that I wouldn't post things online that would offend my employer. Well, guess what? Here I am. That would offend my employer? So basically, oh my God, these people just, I mean, corporate America, whatever you want to call it, they are just doomed beyond belief. You know what? a lot of you will probably say, oh, well, you know what? You talk about this, you talk about that, because it's all a learning experience for everyone else out there. Yes, I just had a part-time job, and yes, when I first started working there, they were wonderful. And then somewhere along the lines, you know, one day, you know, she's like, she just didn't believe that she had to speak to me anymore. The next, you know, they started saying, oh, well, this isn't good enough. You're going to have to do this. And I said, I'm finished with you guys. You guys are taking me for granted. You guys think I'm just a sorry-ass nigga and a workhorse. That's not how I roll. Go find yourself an older guy. Go find yourself an older Anglo to do the job. Because you know what? You're not going to find another motherfucker like me. And that's it. Because guess what? Who needed more than who? And you know what? I take this risk all the time because I've been living here in Thailand for a very long time. And just a day later, boom, four opportunities came. Why? Because opportunities come to those who take the bullshit out of their life. That's what I'm telling you guys to do. Take that goddamn leap of faith. And with that being said, guys, have a wonderful morning, afternoon, and evening. Podcast interview tomorrow morning with David Morrow. This guy scaled Mount Everest, baby. ESL podcast coming tomorrow with another guy, a fitness guru. His name is Tony. This guy is a beast. That's going to be on my ESL channel. So you guys get ready for that one. That will be posted tomorrow. And I got so many other things that are coming up. Oh, and another podcast interview Friday. We got a lot of things. Well, maybe. I'm not even going to talk about that one. But you know what? Just stay tuned for all of the madness. This is your host, Arsenio, as usual. Over and out.